Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to some more Elder Scrolls Arena. This is actually a video that I'm making right after I've completely finished the game and I've completed raiding the Imperial Palace and I fell into the water. I think this is gag music. Anyway, so yeah, what I'm going to be doing now is raiding Stonekeep. This is a remake of a previous video of mine in which I went ahead to raid Stonekeep but couldn't do that because I didn't have enough health potions with me, and I couldn't fetch the objective. So this video will be the same. I will not be touching the objective, but I will go around and explore the rest of Stonekeep to the best of my abilities, actually completely, because right now, as you can see here, I'm a level 21 Nord Warrior with pretty pimped out equipment. So yeah, I don't really think it would be too much of a problem for me at this point, at least. But yeah, I'm not going to be touching the objective. One of the reasons why I have decided to let's go ahead and raid Stonekeep. One of the reasons why I have decided to raid Stonekeep is the fact that this is a starting dungeon, and this is an amazing dungeon which you can return to for loot. I have previously said in my videos that if a cracked sign shrouded in dust reads, "Welcome to Stonekeep, surrender all weapons to the gods, for we are the keepers of peace." Yeah, so basically the thing is, yeah, rats. So Stonekeep is a starting dungeon, and it has got a lot of loot. So if you're looking for loot at any point in the game, this is a wonderful place for you to start. Looting, that is. And some monsters can be a little difficult than the others. For example, there are minotaurs and spiders and ghouls even. And as a beginner, they might be a little difficult for you. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be raiding Stonekeep in its entirety. And as you can see, the map has already been deleted, which is rather sad. So anyway, yeah. So without further ado, let's get to it then. Let's start. The objective, just for reference, is beyond this door here. So we're not going to be touching that door, because that's how I did it in the last video. I'll be doing that with an alternate character. The point of this video is to show you where all the loot is, so that you can loot better and loot faster, so that you can find loot hotspots and get rich quicker. You don't need to repeatedly go to minor dungeons and grind. Just find all the loot hotspots, like this place here. Like, it's not actually a loot hotspot, it's just loot lying around. And as you can see, I've already got enough loot. I've got an amulet as well and a short bow, which I am considering using because I am currently done with this game. So yeah, if you find places like these, go loot them. And yeah, make sure that you check up on how much you can actually, which monsters you can tackle, which monsters you can't, before you go ahead and try this, because some of the monsters are more difficult than others and some of them are easier than others. So it's ultimately up to you which monsters you want to tackle, which monsters you don't. I will be dropping my tower shield of strength here because it is broken and I don't exactly need it. So this is more of a walkthrough video of where all the loot hotspots are. And once you know where all the loot hotspots are, it's highly advisable. An old faded sign reads, "The king and the palace are lost. We, the last survivors of the court of Stonekeep, are heading south through the goblins' caves." Nice cupboard there. So yeah, just make a note of where all of this leads. This is a minotaur, which is going to be extremely difficult for you when you are at a beginning stage. And this minotaur, I literally killed him in one hit when I was playing Stonekeep for the first time. He literally took me around 30 or so hits to kill him. So yeah, make sure to make your adjustments accordingly. This is one of the tougher enemies for beginners. For me, not so much. Moving on. This is a way to go to a place where you will be encountering spiders. So yeah, so once you have made a note of all the loot hotspots that there are in Stonekeep, a good decision would be to just, you know, get into Stonekeep, an old faded sign, okay, fine. This is not a loot body to loot, yeah. So, once you have, like, for example, this is a tiny sack of gold. I'm not really sure whether it is worth it at this point in the game, at this stage in the game. You aren't completely, well, when you aren't as strong as me, basically. So, yeah. So, we came from there. Time to head back into the water, I guess. I suppose this area is clear. So, yeah. Just find an area which you like, find an area which you prefer. The main objective, the area where the main objective lies, is also a good area. Especially if you have like a potion of invisibility or a spell of invisibility. You can just go invisible and take out all the ghouls without any problems there. And yeah. So, thank you for opening. And yeah, just enter Stonekeep, raid the hell out of the place, and just leave. Don't get tangled up in fights unless you absolutely have to, because, well, it's this dungeon isn't really forgiving for beginners, but it has a lot of loot. So, in case you need money to get potions and stuff, keep going back here, keep looting, keep exiting. Don't go ahead and raid. The dank smell of mold and decay rises from the flooded dungeon. An Iron Maiden, completely missed this one. So yeah, don't go for minor dungeons. Stick to major dungeons like these one, like this one, or any other dungeons which you might have in mind. Invest in luck if you want more gold. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Just loot and rinse and repeat. You don't need to do anything more. The problem with minor dungeons is that don't pick up staffs. They don't give you shit. Unless, until you're like a mage or something who uses staffs. So yeah. This lock is an insult to my abilities, I already know. It might not be the same thing for you though. Why was this place locked in the first place? 60 gold pieces, is that why? I guess not. Anyway, it's best to keep saving in this game. I don't really need to, but yeah, just in case the game crashes, it's best that you do. So, the problem with minor dungeons is that they don't really have a lot of items which you can sell. For example, crystals and magical artifacts. If, while you may not want to use them, they do sell for quite a lot. So yeah, if you're a mage, if you want to use them, well, tough luck to you. But artifacts like crystals and marks and stuff like that, they are they're pretty. Can you open, please? I think I'll just use a potion of levitation to get to this, because otherwise there was literally nothing here. What is that? That's the first time I've heard that sound. Nothing here either. Nothing here either. So yeah, they don't. They have got more gold than major dungeons, but even their the major dungeons just have more loot in general, and nice handpiece details, to be honest. Hookahs. I see a hookah here. Didn't expect to see that, but okay. Yeah. So they don't really have as much in terms of quantity, but whatever loot you find in minor dungeons, you can say that it is of superior quality as far as, you know, like major dungeons are concerned in most cases, because finding spots in major dungeons is a task, is a different sort of task on its own. But yeah, it's easier to do in minor dungeons. There's much more loot, but at the same time, it's much more difficult to actually... Yeah, I can't jump while I'm levitating, so we'll have to come back here later. If at all. If at all. And I think I've stopped levitating finally. Nothing here either. No loot here. So yeah. Look for loot hotspots in major dungeons, and when you do find them, make sure to... These are Argonians. Again, might prove a little difficult for beginners, but... not for me. Not for when you're level 21, so just a... Major dungeons just give you more items which you can sell in order to gain money, and yeah, that just helps you out a lot whenever you're looking to grind to gain more gold. So yeah, that. This is a shrine. I can hear spiders, but I can't see them. Do you know the real problem with spiders isn't when you can't see them. It's when you can see them and they disappear. So, yeah, that. So that's what I could hear. Ox. I'll take the path on my left. This first floor can be a little expansive. Compared to the rest of the dungeons that I've just been through, it's really nothing too much for me. Even the enemies, it's more like a cakewalk, but yeah. The orcs are easy enemies, they're not that difficult. Even wolves are pretty easy for as far as enemies are concerned. Why couldn't I fucking see you? Yeah, so wolves are easy, orcs are easy. As long as, you know, you've got half-decent armor on. But at the same time, it's the minotaurs and the spiders which you really need to worry about. Because those guys, given a chance, rip you apart. And you don't want that. If you see one, you can actually run away from them. Make sure you run far enough, your speed is higher. And yeah, you're all done. I can hear ghouls, and what is a ghoul doing here? Now, ghouls are the toughest enemies that you will face in as a beginner. So, the first time I played Stonekeep, man, ghouls, no, they were not a welcome sight at all. They were... I literally, like, lost 10 potions of health on fighting ghouls alone, and in case I haven't... You guys, this already, go for potions of heal true. They heal you for a much greater and surer amount than potions of heal do. Potions of healing, they might heal you like for 50 points, they might heal you for 5 points. It's mostly a gamble. With potions of heal true, they will consistently heal you for like a certain amount, and as a beginner, they can heal you all the way from zero back to full health. So yeah, go for potions of heal true, not for potions of healing. If you can, 70 gold pieces, that's all because of my luck. My luck is high. Oh, wait, I made a mistake. So, yeah, my luck is high at the moment. So, I'm finding a lot of gold from the corpses of my enemies. It might not be the same case for you. Skeletons can be difficult as beginners as well. These guys are heavy hitters, and yeah, basically that these guys are heavy hitters and they take a lot of shots before they go down. That sounds like an orc to me. So what is my disease? Typhoid fever. Do I want to get healed? I mean, I think I should, because it's gonna be a while before my health drops. We are following the goblin's tunnel to the north to make our last stand. I see. The goblin's tunnels to the north. Is this like a side objective or something? Or does this, I guess this probably just adds more to the lure of the place. 72 gold pieces, again, primarily because I have what you would call a high luck, high amount of luck. If you see here, this is the luck, what do you call it? The luck modifier, and yeah, I mean, it's not the highest luck that there is out there, but it is still comparatively high as compared to other people. So yeah, this place, it would seem, is too good as far as loot is concerned. Yeah, die please. I mean, I'm not too afraid of losing health at this point. Keep saving in this game if I haven't told you guys to do this already. Keep saving as much as you can, as often as you can. Otherwise, it's gonna suck for you. So yeah. I'm not really concerned about my health dropping too much at this point because, well, like I said, I am level 20, and Stonekeep being a beginner dungeon doesn't really pose much of a threat to me. So, plus I also need to get my health lower so that I can actually heal myself, because, well, I've got like typhoid fever, as you can see here, and when I use potions of purification, it more ghouls. Okay, didn't exactly expect these guys here. Well, are more ghoulies. Anyway, so yeah, make sure you keep saving, and I need to like get my health lower. This is a curious, so that I can actually heal. So yeah, I'm not gonna let them like hit me for free if that's like what it takes, but yeah, I am interested in getting my health lower. This place is a labyrinth of sorts. I like this extremity of the dungeon. The size of the final dungeon, the size of the Imperial Palace, that will be the final dungeon, by the way. And you might not even get prompted to go there, just letting you know. Like, once you have all the eight staff pieces, that is where you have to go. But yeah, the size of the final dungeon is significantly smaller than the size of this. And yeah, that just seems a little strange to me, is all. We could have probably swam over to see what this site held for us, but yeah, I'm not too eager on swimming. If you would like to, ooh, that is a nice eagle statue right there. Goblins, it's been ages since I saw one. 21 goblins, 21 gold points. So yeah, this these enemies are actually making me nostalgic. The sound you can hear in the background, that's also a goblin, but this guy isn't showing himself because he wants to ambush me when there are other goblins around me. So I'm just gonna save here in case something happens, which it shouldn't, but yeah, you never know. So yeah, like for example, you've got a fair amount of loot here. You can use this. Ooh, this looks amazing. Just look at this bed here. It looks fucking amazing, doesn't it? Is that like a... The chest is moldy, as if it had been submerged in water before being brought here. You know, I guess they're cluing us into the location of where a lot of loot might be. So, in case you can't pick chests open, one thing which you can do is simply hit the P button or the pilfer button, which is this one, and use it on a door or a chest, and yeah, you can basically bash it open. So yeah, right here. So that's where you were. I wonder what you were laughing at. At the end of the video, you know what? Let's just go right now. Let's swim across the water and see what this place holds for us. I mean, I do... Oh, there's an open chest right here. Wait, I already looted this, didn't I? Yes, I literally just came back the way I had already been. I can hear spiders. I haven't exactly decided whether I want to. I'll go for the water source nearest to me. And this one seems pretty near, so yeah. Let them be. You want to be sort of careful when you're swimming, because when you are swimming, your enemies can hit you, but you can't hit them back. So it's sort of a situation which sucks. You should avoid it if you can, but if you can't, a place where you will be safer is under these tunnels right here. So under these tunnels, no enemy can get to you. Vary on your stamina meter. If it drops too low, well, it's basically death. So yeah. So I guess this is the end of this side. I can hear a minotaur. And quite strangely, that isn't even the scariest sound that you can hear in the game. The scariest sound comes from, according to my opinion, is from 1. Liches. 2. Vampires. Liches primarily because, you know, that sound is a shriek. But they're also very difficult to handle. Paralysis grips your body and you succumb to the dark waters of your grave. Oh my god, yeah, you don't want to get paralyzed when you're in the water as well, so that's one thing which you need to watch out for. A fallback plan, having a point where I can fall back to in case something goes south. So, yeah. Now I can see an opening there. I would like to save the game again. Because, well, it's a spider, an itsy bitsy spider, which is also glitched out for some random reason, which I don't know why. So I guess that's also that part of the place. Yeah, anyway, so yeah. Make sure that you keep saving and save often. I think I became a little overconfident and made a rookie mistake in my assumption that, you know, like nothing's gonna happen to me, because it certainly did. And I paid the price for it. It's an Argonian. Now, the problem with... Who the fuck paralyzed me? Yeah. Now, what you can do here is practically back away a little. And, or maybe, you know, get closer. And if you are a spellcaster, you have spells, that is amazing. If you're not a spellcaster, what you do have is... Oh shit, I don't have... Alright, it's fine. I mean, I can use like Firestorm as well. I forgot to sell that crystal. Oh no, wait. I got it right now. I got paralyzed again. Something paralyzed me. Well, if it continues to be this way, then I might as well, like, just not... My mark is broken. Oh yeah, I forgot to equip the proper mark. Something is paralyzing me while I'm in the water, and I can't understand what that is. So that's something new. Whoops. Yeah. Oh yeah, I also got like a short bow. I completely forgot about that. Finally. Something paralyzed me while I was in the water, and that was not really a good experience, per se. So, we've already explored this area, there isn't much there. I guess we'll just continue onwards towards this side, then. If at all there is anything here. You can jump using Shift and J. And, yeah. Okay, so something did paralyze me again, and I would like to see what it is. Sometimes one potion of reaction does not work, you might require multiple. I guess Argonians can paralyze you, lizardmen. It's actually the first time that I've seen one doing it. Huh. We'll get back to you later. I am diseased yet again. Here, I mean, this is practically a throwaway character at this point, because I've already completed the game with this one. I mean, I have completed the game. All characters are throwaway characters at this point. Potion of Purification. These ghouls still did take a lot of life out of me. And that just goes to tell you how dangerous they can be for low levels. I mean, for reference, I am literally level 21 right now. And yeah, with 276 points of health. And the ghouls still managed to do that to me. So I guess that's just a testament to how dangerous ghouls can be. And how dangerous swimming in the water can be. So yeah. More tunnels. Now we've already been there. I guess I'll just follow this path here to return back to It is a little long for a swim, isn't it? I guess we'll just swim it. No worries. Let's save here. Where are we going? Here? Works, I suppose. Swimming. Okay, let's just go ahead and save here again. Just in case, you know, like if we get paralyzed again in the water. That sounded like an orc, but you can never really tell for sure. So yeah. Excuse me. Yeah, so we basically have to go this way and here. And here we are, back where we were. Oh yeah, I forgot, we need a pill for this. Oh, it's an Argonian this time. Or a lizard man. I don't know, I mean, the royal bedchamber. Nice. Is there a queen here? This room and others nearby were offices at one time, but looting and decay have left them mere shells. Can't pick up this book now, can I? Somebody opened a door. That was the sound of a door opening, just for your reference. Oh, it was a rat. No wonder I missed it. Nothing here. Another rat. Now, rats can give you diseases, and so can ghouls. Now, a few ways to go around getting your diseases cured is using a potion of levitation. Sorry, not a potion of levitation, a potion of purification. And a potion of cure poison, a potion of cure disease, or spells of the same. Potion of purification also increases your health. So it's like a really powerful potion, but it is also expensive. It is the most expensive potion out there, as far as I can tell. So, yeah, that. When you are using the potion, make sure to remember that. I can't really see much loot here at this point. The prisons. Okay, so these are the prisons. I came through the prisons. I took a swim in the water and came through the prisons. And I just have to wonder as to who exactly thought that it was a good idea to keep the prisons right next to the water where the prisoners could just swim the fuck out. Anyway, I digress. Choosing this path here. And I once did come here at a previous playthrough. And yeah, this path literally links up to the main entrance. It's right behind the throne room. So as you can see here, there should be an eagle statue here. In a bit. I mean, even the eagle statue is quite nostalgic because I haven't seen that in a long time. These tiny little hand-placed details which make the game what they are right here. So, and this fountain with two eagle statues around it. It's pretty amazing, to be honest. And this, like, a room in the middle of it all. There will be goblins here. And yeah, so that's basically where this goes. Where this path takes us. And I guess I'll raid the center area and then move onwards to this side, because we practically have raided the rest of the map here. So I guess that's pretty much all there is to Stonekeep. So yeah, Goblin has nothing to use. Hey, Gobble. Just make sure that you take care while swimming and make sure that you don't drown. Keep an eye out for the stamina. This is your stamina gauge. All classes have one, not just warriors. Swimming drains it really fast. I'm just going to use a potion of levitation here just so that I don't have to swim. This is a key of some sort. That's quite strange, an iron key. And does the statue have a name, like Theodorus? Remember that name, guys. You're going to need it later. So, yeah. I guess we haven't checked this side out, so what do we have here? Anything? I guess we'll just go back down the rabbit hole again, and T-Rexes. These guys still manage to scare me from time to time. Combine that with the fact that this game doesn't exactly have great sound effects, and yeah. It turns out these sounds that you hear in the background, they actually are sounds that are in the game, and I mean you can actually hear the sound of drums. But then again, I mean they do have a lore explanation for that as well. The explanation basically being that the Elder Scrolls, they are basically Magnus's way of keeping tabs on known. So for those of you who don't know, Magnus was the guy who deserted the creation of Nern. So Nern was supposed to be a project which a lot of people took part in, a lot of gods actually. And the ones who made Nern were the Aedra, and the ones who didn't part in it were the Daedra. Magnus was originally one of the people, and this is one of the problems with the spell of levitation, that as long as it's on you, okay, it finished. One of the problems with the spell of levitation in this game is that when you get up on a raised platform of sorts, the game will immediately start stuttering because you're bobbing up and down and levitating. But anyway, more on that later. Yeah, I guess this is the same place that we had previously visited. Yes, it is. So, moving on. Let's just raid the lower half first and then return here later to raid the upper half. So, yeah. For the creation of Nern, the planet in which the Elder Scrolls takes place. But halfway throughout the creation, he had a few problems. So, I'm really simplifying it because, well... I don't exactly intend to give you the full lore. I will, however, leave is this going where I think it is going? No, it's not. It's fine. Yeah, so... Oh, it doesn't hurt to check, no, does it? Yeah, nothing here. Fair enough for me. Fine enough with me. Anyway, so basically, I'm just going to give you a short explanation of it, because I will leave the links to the entire lore down below in the description in case you guys want to read it. When Mundus was being created, Magnus was one of the people that did not want to create, as in he initially wanted to create it, but halfway through the creation process he realized that actually creating Mundus would be a Prinan Mundus basically. So this is what I said when I talked about goblins ambushing you. They came up from behind me, but they were following me all along. So so low level creatures tend to do that. Midway through the creation, he realized that creating Nern was a pretty bad idea, and he just got him and left, along with a few of his minor god followers. And those were those guys were known as the Magnagi, or the Magnagi. I don't know how you pronounce that name, but yeah. And yeah, they basically left Nern, and they fucked off to their own, whatever they wanted to do. So. Die, please. Yeah, and Magnus basically, when he left, he left huge holes gaping in the fabric of time and space. Basically, to put it basically, called the Orbis. which is the essence of all creation, more like the Elder Scrolls term for universe. He left rips in the universe and went over to his own dimension, his own plane, and yeah, there seems to be nothing here. I smacked that goblin so hard he actually flew over and fell at my feet. Nice. I guess this area is done, unless we want to take a swim and figure out what it is over there as well, which I don't really want to do, so yeah. So yeah, when he did that, he realized that, you know, like, oh, I was stuck on you, fine. I guess that's how the goblins came to be in Stonekeep, because these guys fled through the goblin tunnels, and the goblins, well, they... I shouldn't have saved there, but okay, it's fine, I mean... Yeah, so anyway, the goblins literally, like, came over, and I think we are already at the objective area. The area where the objective is supposed to be. And we shall leave the area without touching the objective. Or do we really want to actually go ahead and complete this game right here, right now, instead of splitting it? Well, you know what, this is going to be a long recording, so might as well just split it up into two parts. Instead of using like a spellcaster, I will just use a warrior to do this. And yeah, that's it. Because, I mean, I don't really think a spellcaster would cut it. I think I would just use a spellcaster for pretty much menial tasks then. Yeah, so anyway, Magnus decided to take an L, but he still does keep tabs on known. Here is where you will find the objective. Or I guess I will make like a playthrough of me coming over and actually looting this place anyway, because, man, I mean, Mark. Because, I mean, I really have a, what do you call it, I didn't exactly pick the objective of up right now, and this is another lootable pile. A human body, you can loot from it. There are a lot of ghouls here, so yeah, make sure to kill them all or at least be invisible to them all. Another body here, 87 gold pieces, and yeah, a skeleton here. Why is a skeleton here? So yeah, that this area inside is a huge loot hotspot. You could like come here again and again if you want to loot. Like if you want good loot, basically, and yeah, that the entrance. You know what? We'll just get to the entrance in a bit. So where was I? Yeah. So Magnus, he basically made rips in the fabric of the universe, and through it, magic started flowing into the universe because. You know, like the Obris is connected to the realm of the gods. This is a very rough area for you, so in case you don't want to like complete this, don't complete it, stay away from it. But if you want like the treasure hotspot here, want to get to it, then yeah, you need to complete it. I'm going to pick up the longsword anyway, just in case it might be something important, and a belt. I seem to have a lot of inventory space now for some reason. I can literally like keep picking up things, and this is what I was saying when I meant that you can get stuck. So anyway, yeah, so the Elder Scrolls are nothing but Magnus's documentation or his observations about the universe and like known and Mundus, his creation. He doesn't want to be involved in it, but he wants to sit back and observe as you know, Known evolves, and he wants to record all the changes that there are in Known. Nothing here either. So, yeah. And the Elder Scrolls are basically what record all the music which occurs on Known, because, well, music is just nothing but another facet of magic in the world of the Elder Scrolls. I know I'm probably butchering like the entire story right now, but yeah, I mean, I'm not exactly as masterful a storyteller as Fudge Muppet is, especially when I'm gaming and commentating at the same time. And yeah, it would seem like we pretty much have covered all there is to cover in Stonekeep, so I guess we would call this a successful raid. If you want to exit Stonekeep, just follow this path here and yeah, move over to the exit. And that's it. That's all you have to do. That is literally all you have to do. Here is where you get the quest from. We'll go back here and Rehad. And that would be it. And I guess I'll just make a new character tomorrow and yeah, start a new game up until Fanglayer. Let's see how it goes. You walk through the gates of Hell, ruled by Prince Fabian. The streets seem strangely quiet. I wonder what that is. Oh, because it's nighttime. So if you roam around at nighttime, you run the risk of being attacked by bandits. So yeah, do it at your own risk. Roaming around at the night, I mean. Bandits, goblins, anything can attack you. There's an infinite possibility of the creatures that can attack you. But anyway, moving on. I will probably be covering that in a general gameplay mechanics video. And yeah, thanks for watching. That is it for today. This is actually finally it for today. I will not be streaming or recording anymore. And thank you for staying with me throughout the series. I know this is probably like the fourth or fifth video. But yeah. Thank you for staying with me throughout the series, and yeah, thank you for watching. Until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.